Hello babes, welcome back. This is my first video being back. I must say you guys, it feels like I haven't picked up a camera in like a month. It is 12 o'clock, I haven't even had breakfast yet, but there's so many things I feel like I need to like fill you guys in on. If you guys are not following me on IG, you guys are missing out on like me cooking. I've been cooking on there. I do a little bit of everything on my Instagram page just like I do on here, so I'll leave it here for you guys. I wanted to show you guys this before I finished it because I always have to share with you guys my new Starbucks drinks. It's funny because the day before I went to get my pumpkin spice as per usual, the girl, yesterday was like, oh, we don't have it anymore. So I'm wondering, like, was I the last one that got it, right? Because I was there the day that she said it ran out. And I was like, okay, whatever. I knew the day was coming that I wasn't gonna be able to get my pumpkin spice, so it wasn't like a shocker, you know what I mean? She's like, do you wanna try your new pistachio latte? And I was like, hell to the no, please no. She's like, honestly, I'm not a big pistachio fan either, and I tried it and I was actually like pleasantly surprised. So this is a grande iced pistachio latte in a venti cup with almond milk. I tried this time. Almond 1000% is at least half the calories of oat. Oat is actually very high in calorie. And I actually put cinnamon and nutmeg on top because I still wanted that like warm kind of vibe, but they put like a brown sugar topping on top of the pistachio. And I tried this sample, it was a hot sample, but I waited till it cooled down, and you guys, it's actually not bad at all. Like, the pistachio is not like in your face if you're not a pistachio lover. So I'll write the drink down below in my description box. Okay, the other thing I wanted to update you guys on, my socks on the floor, because what I end up doing is I get so hot and I like take them off at nighttime. My coffee table, I got this as like a temporary table. A lot of my pieces, some of them were like temporary buys, you know what I mean, where you get them just to have a filler for now. So I'm actually creating my own coffee table, you guys. I am getting rid of this one. I ordered a glass top and I actually did a drawing of what I'm doing. Where's this table on Pinterest that I thought I wanted, but I'm like, am I gonna get sick and tired of the cylinders? But the good thing with this table, you guys, is that the glass top can stay the same and you can keep playing around with it. I ordered two planters, you guys, that are like concrete basically. They're completely flat on the top. They're meant to be risers, but it also says that you can flip them over and then they're open so they can be planters. I've been looking for a base for this damn table for months. And you might be thinking to yourself, well, just get like any planter. But the thing is a planter's open, right? So do I want people to be able to see in the planter as the base? And then if I flip it over, most planters have like a little groove to like sit on the floor, you know what I mean? So it's not completely flat. And then I ordered a custom glass top. I actually decided to go with rectangular shape instead of square or round. I do love to work over there, like edit my videos, but the problem is the tabletop gets really hot. When you're on Final Cut and you're editing, which is what I use, the tabletop gets so freaking hot, especially when it's rendering any edits that you're doing. Notice when I'm on my island over here, man-made like stone material, it kind of offsets the heat. Like my counter never gets that hot. Also is bad for the computer to be on a thing like that because the heat is just constantly like there, you know what I mean? And avoiding kind of editing there unless I'm doing a very quick, simple video that doesn't require a lot of edits. I've been working on my island. Finally gonna get to edit over there again in my living room. And plus, being at home, you are in the same space. So I like to switch up where I'm working. I'm gonna show you guys, probably do like a reel on IG. I'm also constantly changing my decor because it's a part of my job. I love to show you guys. The other thing I'm changing, I do love it, but the thing is, it's like so pretty up here, right? And then you look down and there's shoes. And you might be thinking to yourself, well, just put them inside of your closet. But the thing is, I've always had this habit, my sock. I like to have my basic shoes here. The shoes that I use day in, day out to go out. It's bothering me that they are showing, right? Because every other part of my place is very clean. This was actually not intended to be temporary, but I also didn't want to spend too much on it just in case it was. I feel like I wasn't sure what I wanted here, but this area of my space, I really wanted to do something with it. So I'm like, let me get a console. I got this from IKEA. I'll show you guys a picture. I think it's called a, I don't know. It's gonna be a very low profile, massive drawer. It's actually a toy storage drawer for kids. And sometimes you have to get really creative. But I just personally love kind of changing things up and being like, you know what, that can be used for this. I've always loved like designing and creating things into something else. It also, you can sit on it while you're putting on your shoes, and basically it's going to, the drawer is gonna roll out, and these shoes you see right here, they're gonna go in. And then I'm gonna close it and it's gonna be super clean. But I'm so excited. I feel like it's gonna look more clean, and the black is also a little bit of an accent around my place, but I don't like having too much black. I just hate how these shoes are here, and I know that that habit is not gonna change. You can also put things like your umbrella at the front door inside that drawer. If you guys are in a condo or an apartment, I'm pretty sure I've shown this to you guys, but I know a lot of you guys are new to my channel, and welcome, babes. But for those of you who have been here, you know that this guy is like my right-hand man. It allowed me to carry that piece up, like the wood piece up, and then also the bags. And people that see me, they're like, oh my God, that's such a good idea. And I'm like, I could not like move into an apartment or a condo and not have one of these. Like, it's such a really great help for your groceries. So I'll leave a link on my Amazon for you guys. It's definitely a must have. Like, I can't tell you how much this guy has saved me. And then over here, you guys, this is the vacuum that I got off of Amazon. And let me tell you, you see this part over here? It has a dent. There were scratches along here and everything. It kind of looked used, but then over here the brush roll and everything was like completely new. So this is the vacuum I decided to go with after doing a lot of like research and just kind of asking myself, how do you like to vacuum? What do you like? What do you not like? I feel like the Dysons are just overpriced in my opinion, and I just, not that they're not worth the price, but I just would rather spend my money elsewhere than that much on a vacuum. That's just me. My top thing was that it was super important for me to get one that was amazing with long hair. They sent me out a replacement. It is supposed to come today, so I'll probably do like a more in-depth review. But anyways, I came back from groceries and I didn't realize how much produce I had, you guys. I'm gonna be making pico de gallo, so that's why I needed some red onion. I got tomatoes for that, cilantro, I got avocados, and I also want to make a macaroni salad because I love, love, love macaroni salad, and I just want to make it on my own. It's been a while. I finally bought chopped garlic, and I bought some light mayo for me to do the macaroni salad. Tomatoes, onion, cilantro, I told you guys, spinach, because I'm actually going to be making like a breakfast quesadilla, the one that I showed you guys in my past vlogs that I'm actually really craving. And I also picked up salsa for that as well. And I also got a lime for our pico de gallo. So lots of chopping I gotta do, as you guys can tell. And I love to put them in my, guys, look inside of here, look. Okay. I can't believe I'm showing you guys this. This is ridiculous. But anyways, these bags are what I use to put all my chopped fruits or anything like veggies. I put meat inside of there. They are dishwasher friendly. And I also have some covers in there as well that I use a ton, just so that I'm not using foil or parchment paper or plastic wrap or anything. And you guys can find these bags on my Amazon. They are like, they're constantly inside my freezer. So I have chopped onion inside of here. I have spinach. This is why I have to get a new one, because not new one, but like a new bunch of spinach. What is that? What is this? When you chop it. Oh, this is cabbage. I chopped cabbage so that I wouldn't waste it. Oh, that's good to know, because I can actually use that in like a soup or something. But yeah, I'm constantly, constantly using these bags over here. This is like my frozen fruit, frozen veggie section. But I will leave it down below on my Amazon favorites so that you guys can shop it. I bought my dad to cut me this piece of wood because I'm gonna be doing a DIY, you guys. I think you guys are going to love this. I'll also be doing like an IG reel because I think this is really cute, especially for right now that a lot of us are stuck at home. And you guys, I bought, no, two new bags from Coach that I was just like, oh my God. I've been looking for like a really nice light bag. I don't think I talked to you guys about my hair, but I'll just say it quickly. I feel like this hair, you guys, is just not me. I feel like I got more comments about this hair than I have with my blonde, but then I don't know. Like, I look back at my blonde and people, you guys always just show so much love no matter what. This is your color, like this is you. I just feel so boring with it, you guys. I don't know, before with the blonde hair, I had this thing to me, you know what I mean? And now with this, I just have to say it, it's so freaking boring and it's bland. I'm not saying I wanna go all the way back to what I was before, but I definitely need to add little pieces here and there. But my hair is very dry and it does have damage, so I'm trying to like slow it down. And plus, hair salons are closed. Like, I know a lot of you guys are like, stay with this color, don't go back to the blonde. Amy likes when I first got it done, like a little bit lighter of a brown. And I've also noticed I've been doing my hair less. I haven't been wanting to do it. Guys, I found tape. My like habits is I roll up tape, and it has to be scotch tape. I roll it up like this and I literally just like play with it. it's very like relaxing to me. There's always like a piece here and there, one by my bed, one over here, and yeah. Dear God, I am so over the place. Like, it is what it is, you know? Imagine there's like a bunch of trampolines, okay? And you're jumping around from trampoline to trampoline, and each trampoline represents a different category or thought or something, a different part of what you're thinking about throughout the day. It's exhausting. Behind me, as you guys can tell, if you've watched past vlogs, I showed you guys I did two paintings. I removed the second one because I'm like, it's just not me. It's not minimal enough. So another decor update. Got the small Skylar hobo, which I actually have in black. This is what it looks like. I will leave a link to everything that I got down below. It's so pretty. So you can also have like the crossbody strap, but I never wear it like this. I have this one in black, and the size is so perfect, and it gives you like this vintage vibe. I also took off my nails, you guys. Ew, not in those colors. Watch yourself. So this bag over here is another one that I got. I'm so in love with it, you guys. It has like this channel kind of detail, and I love this. I love when it does the two-sided split, because you can organize your bag if you're really big on organizing, and I am. I like to put all my things that I reach for like all the time when I'm out on one side, and then the other side is for stuff that I kind of carry as extras. And then that's how it looks, you guys. It's so pretty. I cannot wait to get this. This is in the color chalk, so it's kind of like their stone creamy kind of color. Then this was also me clicking on an IG ad once again from Coach. So then I got this wallet over here. I don't have a wallet this color in like the stone chalk, so I did want to get one so that it can be like a staple color. Is on sale for $65. So I did get those three pieces. I'm so excited. They've already shipped, but it does take a while because this is USD. So for all my Canadians, it is going to charge you in USD, but you do not get charged custom fees, okay? Just so that you know, you do not get charged for customs. I'll leave a link for you guys down below so that it's super easy for you guys to click on it. I started watching some show suggestions that Amy has. First show that I watched is The Wilds, and oh my God, you guys, must watch. Yeah, it's free here in Canada, but people were telling me in the States that it's not free. I was asking you guys to pay for it. I feel like it was a 10 out of 10. The other show I watched is Little Fires Everywhere. Oh my God. This one was also on Prime. I feel like it was very just different, but also extremely deep. And I love shows that get really deep because I'm deep. So I just don't like when it's too like expected. Like, don't dirty my new Walmart shirt. I think people said also on Hulu, is that how you pronounce it? Hulu? I don't know because I don't have that channel. Big Little Lies, that also has Reese Witherspoon in it as well. It didn't like blow me away. It was more of like an 8 out of 10, but it was a really good show still. That one was on Crave, so you had to have Crave to watch that one. I don't know if it's different in the States. One show where I was like, oh hell no, I'm not watching this shit. I'm just not watching it. Is Bridgerton. I think that's how you pronounce it. I don't know. But I posted that and I was like, I cannot watch shows from like that time era. Like, I just feel like I can't relate. I don't understand what the hell you're saying. They just speak differently. I'm just not into that like Harlequin kind of vibe. You know what I mean? Everyone, when I said that, they're like, I know, me too, Steph. But trust me, it was good. It was so good. You have to watch it. You know what? I'm gonna try this. I'm gonna try it for y'all, and y'all better be right. I finished it last night. It took a good 3 to 4 episodes for me to actually like start to even get into it. Finding myself like fast forwarding sometimes. I was like, okay, I don't wanna see this. Like, I don't care. But like, there was pretty intense, you know, intimate scenes between the two, and like, it made you go like, oh my God. Like, those scenes were like, just the anticipation, like you kind of felt like a part of it type of thing. I watched it just because everybody was raving, but it wasn't amazing. It's just like, got invested in the couple and their kind of like romantic love story and stuff. And it was intriguing to see like how things were so different. Like, they called periods like courses. They were like, I'm waiting for my course. And I'm like, your course? Is this college or something? Kind of interesting to see that part and how things like kind of used to be. I would say that one's like a 7 out of 10 for me. And they included like modern songs in there and everything. And those are the 4 shows that I watched, but I definitely would say my favorites were The Wilds and little fires everywhere. Like, oh my god, like now I just want like more seasons. Come on, let's go, let's go. If you have any other suggestions though on what I should watch, let me know down below. I'm gonna chop the rest of this up and I'm gonna wait for my vacuum and then I'll show you guys that. My H&M package came in. By the way, I'm obsessed with these slippers, you guys, that I got for Christmas from Amy. I am so obsessed. I will leave a link to them down below and they are linked on my Amazon page. They're so comfortable. I got this set from H&M and typically I'm not too much of a hoodie kind of girl. I love my crew necks, but sometimes I love and I just want like a full set. Mind and body movement on the pants and then same thing on the hoodie. I also got the top and the bottom in both a small. And I swear sometimes, you guys, I have like body dysmorphia. I feel like we all kind of do sometimes where we look at something and I literally saw this hoodie. I'm like, oh my god, I should have gotten a medium. It's going to be like tight on me. And I'm like, Steph, you said that last time and then you put it on and it was like a pool on you. And that's exactly what it is. It's like super loose and baggy on me. So I got this sweater. It's just a ribbed kind of oversized sweater and it has two, that's just a red thing, has like two slits on the side over here. I love it because it can be used as like a lounge piece, a pajama kind of top, or you can wear it out with jeans. I also did get this one in a small and it is massive, I will say. Like, this is crazy oversized. Comment down below if you guys are like that when you get new things. You already want to unpack it. You already want to start using it. It's funny because Amy's the opposite. She kind of like puts it away. And I'm like, you're never going to use that. Like she, oh my god, she's notorious for that. She never uses new things like right away. This is how big this sweater is. I could have gone with an extra small. So anytime an H&M sweater says like oversized, you can go a size down. Trust me, because I actually heard that H&M switched their sizing like over 2 or 3 years ago. How it's like so roomy and you can use it as like a lounge piece, a pajama piece, just with like some tight leggings. I will leave a link to both of these down below for you guys so that you guys can check them out. All right, babes, the new vacuum literally came right after I got this package. God bless me. I didn't want to charge the battery constantly. I didn't want to have to be like, oh, how much do I have left? Oh, let me hurry up or let me charge the battery. The cord does not bother me. I had my cordless vacuum before this and it just wasn't a good vacuum. So, but I will say it is a lot lighter. I realized, you guys, that I really prefer having this over here because one thing I didn't like, I had to have the canister and everything and you had to hold that. It was a little bit like chunky and I felt like I couldn't like maneuver myself, and if I wanted it to like do this, you weren't able to. It was just that it was stiff, you know what I mean? But this expands. I did not know that. So I really like getting to my baseboards and I love this for cleaning out the sofa. I just feel like the cord is just easier and I don't have the canister over here, but I believe this is for the pet hair on your sofa. This I'm gonna be using for my baseboards, but not with the brush. I'm gonna be using it like this. And I love getting into the crevice of my sofa because that is where I eat. Let me tell you, can carry it like this and then have this and be doing your baseboards, and this does not have to be attached to your actual vacuum. I feel the need to maybe do like a quick cleanup. That's another beauty about this one. You even have this sitting on the floor. I would say this feels like a good 7 to 8 pounds here. People would go in their stairs, they would hold this and then they would do the stairs. This is really great if you're doing a quick cleanup, have it on the floor, do your baseboards, or get into a little area that you want to do. The last one, the brush absolutely sucked. I think the brand was like Teneco or something like that. This cost me like, I think it was $265 plus tax or whatever, and this vacuum does like 20 times more what that vacuum does. This one is originally $4.99, but I got the Boxing Day deal when I was watching so many videos. It has the dual clean, and the dual clean means that it has the two brushes over here and it also has the soft at the back. This soft roller is mainly for when you are on like hard floor surfaces. So this back one over here is designed to pull the hair in and it continuously spins, and eventually it'll just suck it up. Like, especially my bathroom is gonna be a really big test with this because I constantly have long hair in my bathroom. I'm probably gonna have to like use this vacuum for a bit to give you guys my thoughts now that I think about it. It's really easy, and also at the back here, you guys, it does have the two little stations where you can put both brushes. Click the lift away button over here, and when you click it, this thing literally lifts off. And you can remove, obviously, this part over here. Actually, I don't mind the purple, to be honest with you. This is rubber and it's such a smooth, soft finish. I'm super excited to just use it. You better clean, cause you cost me $300. I'm gonna go kind of be with my new vacuum. See ya, guys. Her name is Violet. The other one inside the den, she got scratched up. She scratched up Violet. She the refurbished version of you, but she ain't the original version of you. You are the original. Scratch free, dent free, just how I like my new things. I'm so excited to use you, girl. Sucks, I'm so sorry. It's just how I show my love. You'll get used to it, girl. Her name is Violet. If you get one, you're not allowed to name yours Violet too, because she's the one and only Violet. I really like this purple, you know? Watch yourself, Violet. You think you're cuter than me? That you will never be. Comment down below if you are Team Shark or Team Dyson. Look at what it just deep cleaned out of my carpet. What the hell? Remember that keeping a positive mindset, no matter what is going on, is so powerful. I'm practicing that. I'm trying to every single day, no matter what. Even if I'm overwhelmed or if I'm stressed out about something. But here we are on lockdown, so everything is closed. You can pick up like food, but you can't like dine. There's like no more dining in. You can obviously go to the grocery stores and stuff like that, so you don't have to like go crazy and like stock up. The grocery store was crazy quiet. If you guys are not following me on IG, make sure you guys do, because I'm gonna be doing this DIY. Yeah, if you guys are curious what I'm gonna be doing with that, go to my IG page and check out my reel on it. When I get the Coach bags, y'all already know I'm gonna show you guys what they look like and everything, but I will also be showing them probably before on IG. Let me know what other videos you guys want to see on my channel, because it's really great to get your feedback on what you guys want to see, because that matters to me too. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this vlog. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see all of my beautiful babes in my next video.